Hello everyone, welcome to the 10th session in this lecture series on genetics and molecular biology. I'm Dr. Yogesh Pawde. Till this session, we have covered the structure and functions of DNA and RNA under this competency BI 7.1. Now we are moving on to the cell cycle. In this session, we'll discuss cell cycle and related checkpoints and its regulation. At the end of the session, students shall be able to describe cell cycle, explain checkpoints in cell cycle, explain cell cycle control system and regulation of cell cycle. Coming to cell cycle, what is cell cycle? It is just an alternation between interphase and mitosis. So what is interphase? G1 phase, S phase, that is stationary phase, and G2 phase together comprise the interphase, and this is the mitotic phase. So this is just an alternation between interphase and mitosis, that is the cell cycle. The repeating pattern of cell growth, that is increase in cell size, and followed by its division in the mitotic phase. Splitting of one cell into two is called cell cycle. So what happens in this various phases of cell cycle? What are the restriction points? The points which are highlighted with this arrow, red arrow, are the restriction points. And G0 is the stationary phase, when there is no cell growth happening. That is stationary phase. The chromosomes replicate to form sister chromatids during stationary phase. So in this stationary phase, the chromosomes are duplicated. They replicate to form sister chromatids. The sister chromatid, segregate to daughter cells during mitotic phase. So here the chromosomes are replicating to form sister chromatids, which are later on getting segregated in the mitotic phase. This G1 phase and this G2 phase are the gaps between synthesis phase and mitotic phase, during which most cell growth takes place. In multicellular organisms, some terminally differentiated cells stop dividing, like neurons, they stop dividing and arrest in G0 phase. After this part of G1 phase, the cells will stop dividing, those will be terminally differentiated and will arrest in G0 phase, and there is no cell division later on. Interphase consists of G1, S and G2 phases that we have discussed. Only a small part of the cell cycle is spent in division. Little part is spent in division, that is mitotic phase. And period between the mitosis divisions is called as interphase, which comprises of G1, stationary phase S, and G2 phase. G1 lasts from the birth of the new cell. Here the birth of the new cell will happen to the onset of the chromosome replication here. So G1 phase lasts from the birth of the new cell to the onset of chromosome replication for genetic material. It is a period when the chromosomes are neither duplicating nor dividing. During this time, the cell achieves most of its growth by using the information from the genes which are inherited. To make and assemble the material, it needs to function normally. So, what is the material required? It requires RNA for the subsequent protein synthesis. The protein synthesis will attribute to cell growth. So, this is G1 phase. It varies in length more than any other phase of the cell cycle. So G1 phase is the longest phase in the cell cycle. In rapidly dividing cells of the human embryo, like when the growth is happening very rapidly, definitely the G1 phase is going to be short in those cases, maybe as short as few hours. In contrast, as we have discussed, the brain cells, they become arrested in G0 phase. There is no further cell division is happening. In that case, the G1 is now arrested in G0 phase. G0 phase is going to be the lifelong phase of the cell cycle in case of cells which are not dividing, like neuronal cells. Coming to S phase, that is synthesis phase. And it is the time when a cell duplicates its genetic material by synthesizing DNA. So in this phase, there is DNA replication, histone synthesis is there, centrosome is formed, and chromosomes are duplicated. During duplication, each chromosome doubles to produce identical sister chromatids that will become visible when the chromosomes condense at the beginning of the mitosis. Here, when the chromosomes are condensed, the sister chromatids will be visible at the centromeres. Two sister chromatids are joined. This joint structure is considered a single chromosome as long as the connection between the sister chromatids is maintained. That is considered as a single chromosome. The replication of chromosomes during S phase is crucial. This phase is very crucial because the genetic material which needs to be copied exactly so that both daughter cells receive identical set of chromosomes. All the processes here like DNA replication, histone synthesis, formation of centrosome and chromosome duplication has to be error free so that the cell enters into the next phase, that is preparation of mitosis in G2 phase. In G2 phase or gap 2 we call it, it is the interval between chromosome duplication which ends here and beginning of mitosis. The beginning of mitosis will start here. During this time the cell may grow usually less than during G1. So G2 phase is shorter than G1 phase. It also synthesizes proteins that are essential to the subsequent steps of mitosis itself. So each phase in the cell cycle prepares the entire cell machinery for the next phase of the cell cycle. So S phase has prepared the cell for G2 phase to start preparing for the mitosis. So the G2 phase will prepare the cell for mitosis phase, M phase. This G2 phase, you know, the cell synthesizes proteins that are essential to the subsequent steps of mitosis itself. The proteins required for cell division, chromosome separation and mitosis, entire mitosis process will be synthesized in G2 phase. And in addition, during interphase, an array of fine microtubules crucial for many biochemical processes become visible outside the nucleus. Those microtubules are also synthesized during the interphase. The microtubules radiate out into the cytoplasm, you know, forming a single organizing center known as centrosome. It is usually located near the nuclear envelope. In animal cells, you know, the discernible core of each centrosome is a pair of small, darkly stained bodies called as centrioles. So, centrosome and centrioles. The microtubule organizing center of plants does not contain centriole. So, this is the difference between animal cells and plant cells. So, far as G2 phase is concerned, then that difference lies in centrioles. During S and G2 phase, the centrosomes replicate, producing two centrosomes that remain in exactly close proximity. This happens in both the phases, S phase and G2 phase. I'm not talking about chromosome duplication, I'm talking about centrosome replication, which happens in two phases, that is S phase and G2 phase together. Coming to the various checkpoints in cell cycle, we have discussed a general principle in regulation of cell cycle that each phase or stage of a cell cycle prepares the cell for the next stage or the phase. Okay, there has to be some regulatory checkpoint which will decide, you know, and proofread whether the processes in the previous step has completed properly and whether the cell is actually ready for the next phase of the cell cycle. So let us see what are the checkpoints in cell cycle. The cell cycle is a complex sequence of precisely coordinated events. Please refer to the red wedges for the cellular checkpoints. These checkpoints ensure the sequential coordination of important cell cycle events. At each checkpoint, the cell determines whether prior events have been completed properly or not before it can proceed to the next step of the cell cycle. And at the checkpoint, the cell evaluates the result of previous steps, allow the sequential coordination of cell cycle events. Let us take an example of regulation here. Before the cell undergoes mitosis, the enzymes operating in one type of checkpoint, you know, monitor DNA replication to ensure that the cell does not begin mitosis until all the centrosomes have been completely copied. Only after that point, the cell will undergo mitosis. If this checkpoint did not exist, at least one of the daughter cells would lose DNA every cell cycle. That's why we say that the cell cycle is a complex sequence, but it has a precisely coordinated events because of these checkpoints. In higher organisms, a cell's division to divide depends on two intrinsic factors. Which are they? The conditions within the cell and signals from the environment. The conditions within the cell that register a sufficient size for division. So, you know, whether the cell has attained a proper size before it gets divided. Do we have a proper reserve of protein or the protein required for replication before it undergoes a division? And signals from the environment, such as hormonal cues or contacts with neighboring cells that encourage or restrain division. So, because of the external factors or external stimulus or hindrance, the cell will divide or will get arrested in the stationary phase. So, these are the two intrinsic factors on which the cell's division is dependent. Once the cell has initiated events leading to division, usually during the G1 period of interphase, everything else follows like clockwork. Now, which stage is deciding cell's division? It is the G1 phase of interphase. Coming to the checkpoints in cell cycle where there are chances of disturbances or malfunction. The breakdown of the mitotic machinery can produce division mistakes that have crucial consequences for the cell. What are the mistakes in division can occur? There can be improper chromosome segregation. It can cause serious malfunction or even the death of the daughter cells. Gene mutations that disrupt mitotic structures such as spindle, kinetochores or centrosomes are one source of improper segregation. The other problems occur in cells where the normal restraints on cell division such as checkpoints have broken down. Such cells may divide uncontrollably leading to tumor. So what are the factors or checkpoint disturbances? One is improper chromosome segregation or genetic mutations leading to disruption of mitotic structures, and that may happen in spindle, kinetochore or centrosomes. And thirdly, the normal restraints on cell division are lost and cell may divide uncontrollably. Okay, these are the checkpoint disturbances. Now we will move on to cell cycle control system. This is the cell cycle control system. Listen to the explanation properly on this slide because it is a very complex slide. So we'll go slowly. Here, the cell can progress to the next cell cycle stage only when the feedback controls have ensured the integrity of the genome that we have discussed. The progression of the cell cycle is regulated by interconvergent processes. Various proteins, activators, inactivators are undergoing interconvergent processes and it leads to progression of the cell cycle. In each phase, special serine-threonine specific protein kinases are formed. Serine-threonine protein kinases are formed, which are known as cyclin-dependent kinases, CDKs. This term is used because they have to bind an activator protein that is cyclin. So, cyclin-dependent kinases have interaction with cyclin D in order to become active. At each control point in the cell, specific CDKs associate with equally phase-specific cyclins. So, you will understand that in each stage or phase of the cycle, there are phase-specific cyclins and cyclin-dependent kinases. That's why there is good coordination between the phases of the cycle because CDKs and cyclins are phase-specific. An important member of this family of protein is CDC2, also called as CDK1. CDC2 here refers to CDK1, cyclin dependent kinase 1. Other proteins act as rate limiting step in cell cycle progression and are able to induce cell cycle arrest at defined stages. What are those defined stages? Those are checkpoints. So the rate limiting steps are checkpoints just because there are certain proteins, activation or deactivation of those proteins induce cell cycle for its progression. The cell is induced to progress through G1 by growth factors, those are mitogens, acting through receptors that transmit signals to proceed towards the S phase. D-type cyclins are D1, D2 and D3 are produced, which associate with and activate CDK4 and CDK6. There are proteins which can arrest G1 also. The detection of DNA damage and subsequent cell cycle arrest due to activated P53 is an important mechanism for preventing the cell from entering the S phase, so that the cell arrests its growth in G0 phase. So P53 activation will lead to cell cycle arrest. In early G1 phase, CDK1, that is CDC2, is inactive and it is activated in late G1 here, just before the restriction point. Before the cell enters into S phase, there will be activation of CDK1 by associating with G1 cyclin such as cyclin E. So cyclin E associates with CDK1 to activate it. Once the cell has passed the G1 restriction phase, cyclin E is degraded and the cell enters the S phase. So later part of G1 is the deciding factor whether the cell enters S phase or not. Before that, P53 activation will decide whether the cell undergoes cell arrest or not, depending on the genetic architecture of the cell. For other cells which have to enter into S phase, there the CDK1 cyclin E association will, just before the entry point, there will be activation of CDK by cyclin E, CDK1 gets activated and just the cell passes the G1 restriction point here, the cyclin E or G1 cyclin will be degraded and the cell enters into S phase. When this is initiated among many other activities by cyclin A binding to CDC2, that is CDK1. And phosphorylation of the RB protein, retinoblastoma protein. Here, in this stationary phase, cyclin A binds to CDC2, that is CDK1, and phosphorylates retinoblastoma protein and other proteins also. This CDC2 is activated by association with mitotic cyclin A and cyclin B to form the mitosis promoting factor. Here, CDK1, that is CDC2, binds to mitotic cyclin A and B to form mitosis promoting factor. And during mitosis, cyclin A and B are degraded and an anaphase promoting complex is formed. The activity of CDK cyclin complex is then terminated again by proteolytic cyclin degradation. The cell passes through the mitotic checkpoint only if no damage is present. There is no DNA damage. The CDK cyclin complex is activated by phosphorylation and or by dephosphorylation. The activated complex in turn phosphorylates transcription factors which lead to the formation of the proteins that are required in the cell cycle. Phase concerned enzymes or cytoskeletal component and other CDKs and cyclins also. The intracellular concentration of cyclin B increases constantly until mitosis starts. Right from here, the intracellular concentration of cyclin B will go on increasing. It increases throughout that S and G2 phase, but it degrades rapidly once the mitosis starts. When mitosis has been completed, cyclin B is marked with ubiquitin and broken down proteolytically by proteasomes. Protein phosphatases then regain control and dephosphorylates the protein involved in mitosis. So, after the dephosphorylation of the protein involved in mitosis, the mitosis process will stop and the cell will enter into G1 phase. The mitosis is completed, CDK1, that is CDC2, is inactivated by S phase inhibitor, that is SIC1. This inhibitor will inactivate CDK1, that is CDC2, and the cell returns to the interphase. So, to summarize the cell cycle, see carefully, before the entry point into the next phase, there is association of cyclins with CDC2, that is CDK1. It gets associated. Once the cell enters into next phase, those cyclins which were associated are degraded. Here also, the CDK1 binds to cyclin A and B, forms mitosis promoting factor. The concentration of cyclin B is increased up to this point. Once the cell enters into mitosis, the M cyclins A and B are degraded rapidly here, and the anaphase promoting complexes form. And once the mitosis is completed, the CDK1 gets inactivated by SIC1 and RB is dephosphorylated and the cell enters into G1 phase. So, if you go slowly and understand the overall sequence of events in cell cycle, you will understand the restriction points also. G1 phase is dependent on the cell's genetic architecture. Cells in different tissues will have different G1 phases. So, the time is not shown here. Usually, the synthesis phase in all type of tissue occurs for only 6 to 8 hours. Then, G2 phase where there is replication repair will be completed in 3 to 4 hours, and the mitosis phase is the shortest phase which continues for 1 hour. Okay, now we will discuss about the interaction of cyclin A, B and mitosis promoting factor in next slide. The entry of cell into mitosis, right, here is based on the mitosis promoting factor, that is MPF. This MPF, the explanation of this MPF we have given in this diagram. The MPF consists of CDK1 and cyclin B. Remember the explanation in the previous slide. The MPF has two components, CDK1, that is CDC2 and cyclin B. This is cyclin B and this is CDK1. Okay. Cyclin B has a structure which gets fit into CDK1, and there is a sequence of phosphorylation and dephosphorylation of CDK1 and cyclin B which decides the phosphorylation of proteins necessary for mitosis. So, this mitosis promoting factor actually phosphorylating protein required for mitosis, and the sequence of event for phosphorylation of these proteins is activated by interaction between cyclin B and CDK1. This MPF, that is mitosis promoting factor, is inactive initially because CDK1 is phosphorylated. This CDK1 is phosphorylated initially, though it is combined with cyclin B, it will be inactive. It will be inactive when CDK1 is phosphorylated and cyclin B is dephosphorylated. There is no phosphate group attached to cyclin B. The M phase is triggered when a protein phosphatase dephosphorylates the CDK. This CDK is dephosphorylated and cyclin B is phosphorylated by the kinase at the same time. So, both the enzyme occurring at the same time, dephosphorylation of CDK1 and phosphorylation of cyclin B is occurring, catalyzed by two enzymes, that is phosphatase and kinase. Here the phosphate group from CDK1 is removed and the phosphate group is attached to cyclin B by the enzyme kinase. In its active form, this is the active form. Now you can see that phosphate group is attached to cyclin B and there is no phosphate group attached to CDK1. So CDK1 is dephosphorylated, cyclin B is phosphorylated, and the complex is mitosis promoting factor. And this factor in its active form, this active form via phosphorylated cyclin B in MPF phosphorylates various proteins. So all the proteins will be phosphorylated by this mitosis promoting factor. Which are those proteins? A list of proteins like histone, H1 protein, laminin, protein kinases, transcription factors, and various other proteins are also involved which undergo phosphorylation and will lead to preparation of the cell for mitosis. What are those processes which needs to be, you know, ready for cell to undergo mitosis? These are spindle formation, chromosome should be condensed before that, disappearance of nuclear membrane, and transcription stop cyclin degradation. So cyclin has to be degraded so that the cell enters into the next phase of the cell cycle. So this was the role of mitosis promoting factor in preparation of the cell for mitosis. These are the references used for preparation of the presentations for this competency and the entire lecture series. You can refer this literature for further deeper studies. Thank you very much for watching the video. Hope you have subscribed to the channel and pressed the bell icon and selecting all so that you get all notifications of the upcoming videos in future. Thank you very much once again. Keep watching, keep learning, and keep motivating us.